So, math, chemistry, chapter 1, matter in our surroundings, part 3. So, in this, what are all the topics covered? That is sublimation, effects of pressures on gases, evaporation and its factors, interconversion of three states of matter, evaporation causes cooling. So, what is mean by the term sublimation? That is, it is one interesting chapter. That is, solids will directly converted into gas without becoming liquid. That is called as sublimation. So the best example is camphor, or we can take ammonium chloride in a china dish. In this china dish, either we can take camphor or we can take ammonium chloride. Just you want to close with inverted funnel. The top of the, that is mouth of the funnel, should be closed with cotton. And you have to heat this china dish with burner. So after sometimes, if you see, some smoky things will be going off, that is stick on the sides of the inverted funnel. That is ammonium chloride solidified. That is gases converted into a solid states without becoming into liquid. That is called as sublimation process. And next we are going to see effect of pressure on gases. Suppose if you apply some pressure on gases, what it will become? It will be converted into a liquid state. That is, when pressure is applied on gas, the particles will come closer and closer, the gases changes into liquid state. This principle is applied in your normal liquefied petroleum gas, that is the LPG cylinders what we are using in the domestic. That is, usually inside that only liquid will be present, that is gases will be compressed, so the molecules will come closer and closer, or the particles will come closer and closer. It is converted into liquid. Again, if you turn off the burner or a stove, automatically if it comes in contact with the atmosphere, so it catches fire, it will be converted into gaseous state. That principle is applied in your cylinders, that is day to day we are using in our kitchen. So compressed solid carbon dioxide is called as dry ice. If the pressure is reduced, it changes directly to gas without coming into liquid state. So solid carbon dioxide is also known as dry gas. So this is the next one, that is interconversion of three states. Already you know that solid is converted into liquid, liquid is converted into gas. So again, the gas can be converted into liquid and liquids can be converted into solid. So this is interconversion. Already we know that is, it is a reversible reaction. So when solid is converted into liquid, that process is called as fusion. Again, if liquid is converted into solid, that process is called as solidification. Suppose if liquid is converted into gas, that process is called as vaporization. If gas is converted into liquid, it is called as condensation process. Suppose if gas is converted into solid, that is called as deposition process, or solid is converted into gas, we already know it is a sublimation process. That is three interconversion of three states of matter. And next topic is a very interesting topic, that is evaporation. Simply, if you keep some water, after it absorbs some heat from the sunlight, it will start, water will start to evaporate. That is the change of liquid into vapors at any temperature below its boiling point is called as evaporation. Usually evaporation is happens only in the surface, so it is called as surface phenomenon. When particles from the surface gain energy to overcome the force of attraction and changes to vapor state. So what are all the major factors affecting evaporation? Suppose the, what are all the major factors affecting evaporation is your surface area, temperature, humidity is nothing but moisture, and wind speed. Suppose if the increase in surface area, the rate of evaporation is very high. Suppose if you keep water in a tumbler, or if you keep some water in a plate, the water which contained in the plate will start to evaporate very fastly than water containing in the tumbler. So the surface area, if it is very high, the evaporation will be also high. Increase in temperature increases the rate of evaporation. The best example for this is during summer season, the water which is present in the pond, lake will start to evaporate very fastly compared to winter. So if temperature is high, evaporation rate is also high. Increase in humidity decreases the rate of evaporation. For example, during winter season, the rate of evaporation is very slow compared to summer season, because in winter season moisture content will be present. So due to moisture, there will be the evaporation rate is very low. In summer season, that is, the moisture content is very low, so automatically evaporation rate is very high. Increase in wind speed increases the rate of evaporation. Suppose if the speed of wind is very high, the evaporation rate will be also very high. So here is the pictorial representation of evaporation. Usually evaporation takes place on the surface, so we are telling that as a surface phenomenon. So here high energy evaporating molecules will be present on the surface, and medium energy molecules will be present in the middle, and in lower it will remains as a liquid as such. And then evaporation causes cooling. For example, when liquid evaporates, the particles of the liquid absorb heat from the surrounding and evaporates. So the surroundings becomes cold. The best example for that is during summer season, we are often getting sweat. So to absorb heat from our body to make it cool, we always use cotton cloths. So this is the best example, that is evaporation causes cooling. Another one example is during summer season, we often sprinkle some water on the roof or rooftop, because it will absorb heat and makes the surface cool. So this is evaporation causes cooling. And thank you very much.